Hello Internet, so let me introduce you the things in the video that I'm going to show you right now. So there's a transparent tube used in it in which there are two magnets. One magnet which is at the base and another magnet which my friend is dropping. So the reason why the transparent tube is used is because the repulsive forces between the magnet are so strong that the magnets do fly off, and even so that we can see what's happening inside the tube.
First of all, ignore me in the back. So now, as I drop the magnet, gravity takes over. But as the magnets come close enough, the repulsive force between them won't allow them to touch. The magnet that I released just bounces off from a distance where the magnetic field is very strong. And then, after a few bounces, it starts to levitate. This is just due to the repulsive force between the two magnets.
Same principle works here. Frogs, like everything around us and inside us, are made up of millions and billions of atoms. Each of these atoms contains electrons that whiz around a central nucleus. But when atoms are in a magnetic field, the electrons shift in their orbit slightly. This shift gives the atom its own magnetic field. So when a frog is in a very strong magnetic field, it is essentially made up of a lot of tiny magnets. And there's nothing special about frogs. All materials, including water and gold, are diamagnetic substances. So diamagnetic substances are essentially materials that oppose an external magnetic field when there's a strong magnetic field applied to them.
The frog acts like a diamagnetic material, opposes the magnetic field, and hence levitates. So this was it for today. Please do like this video, share this video with your friends, hit the subscribe button that's under the video or click the screen to subscribe. Click on the thumbnails to watch my previous videos, and as always, stay curious, stay awesome.